Right now, we want to focus on an area of Kansas City that has become synonymous with the visual arts, the Crossroads Art District, with First Fridays, the 18th Street Fashion Show, and Third Fridays even.
So we talked with some of the key players down there about where it started and where they think it might be going.
Sisters Betsy and Emily Blodgett of Bon Bon Atelier in Westport. We're inspired by Edwardian beachwear.
The 18th Street Fashion Show started with one of the businesses that I rent to 8 years ago. It's morphed to include dozens of designers over the years and thousands of people. It, like a lot of the artists in the neighborhood, draw what our Convention and Tourism Bureau would love to be able to draw. National attention in national magazines and repeated exposure to the cultural leaders in our city. You know.
The 18th Street Fashion Show has been a summertime staple in the Crossroads since 2001. It began when a former West 18th Street merchant sought a creative way to showcase emerging talent in fashion and design. That same need to showcase emerging talent is what spawned the Crossroads area itself over 20 years ago.
The Crossroads is, some people think it's a made-up name. It's no different than Westport or Fairway or Brookside. It's on the city charts as a real name, and this neighborhood converges on roads that are running along the railroad tracks. So the roads are running crossways to parallel streets. We also like the name Crossroads, where you're going down a path and then you come to that crossroads and then you don't really know where you're going.
I opened the third gallery in the district. And what we did for the area is we brought the alternative energy from some of the further places outside of the Crossroads, if you will. And it wasn't even called the Crossroads back then. It was the Freight House District, it was the Film District, it was Leedy Art Center District. Everyone had their own name then. We kind of just came to the idea of saying, let's just call it the Crossroads. I don't remember what day it was. We didn't really have a big ribbon cutting ceremony. It was just, for this day forth, we'll be called the Crossroads. But it's kind of, you know, the center of the country, center of ideas, center of images, center of people, and you know, it kind of came together that way.
It's recently become more of a cultural hub, more of a an arts-based neighborhood. But that also was the case when Film Row and the film distribution and jazz booking for the neighborhood occurred there in the Crossroads. Historically, there was a greater connection between the Crossroads and the 18th and Vine, 12th and Vine area.
The Crossroads just so happens to be a creative neighborhood where a lot of people in different disciplines have kind of a creative outlook in how they go about their daily business.
Moved down here in this neighborhood maybe about 16 years ago and started a gallery with the encouragement of Jim Leedy and many of my friends that were artists that had no place to show. And not much of a gallery scene really going on then. And fell in love with Jim Leedy. There's a lot of people that might look at him and just say he's an old hippie. They don't realize he's got many masters, he's got PhDs. He's very, very driven. He has spent his entire life in his studio making. When I first met him down here to have a meeting about moving down into this neighborhood, we looked at the space and kind of talked about it. We kind of made a commitment to one another that we would work together to try to do what his dream was. And some of the ideas of this neighborhood, I feel, were ideas that he had about a Midwest city and kind of what we were lacking here. But also, I believe some of the ideas are Fuller's ideas about how you build kind of a utopia and what it takes to kind of build a community. And they're kind of, you know, sometimes very simple things of encouraging people to dream.
And John's dreams are taking him out west to a new location in the West Bottoms. When Crosby Kemper expressed interest in buying the Dolphin, O'Brien saw both an opportunity for building on his dreams and for helping the neighborhood he'd been a part of all these years.
I'm very excited about a museum space coming into the Crossroads. I think it's a real stamp of approval that having Crosby become interested in this neighborhood and interested in the scene here, I think will be a really big step for the neighborhood.
And you can't talk about the Crossroads neighborhood without mentioning First Fridays. In fact, for many people, Crossroads and First Fridays are synonymous.
We just kept hearing such great things about the atmosphere and the food and the excitement of the artwork, and we hadn't explored a lot of galleries, so we thought this would be a great time to do that.
I think that's the most beautiful thing about art, is like it's sharing ideas, and so to have a venue where people come and see and look at this stuff and get ideas from and think about things differently.
I think a lot of people like to come down to look at people.
You walk through and you see people with spiked hair and you see people in tuxedos. I always like a dynamic like that.
I love First Fridays. Fridays are intended to be reception for the artists at the galleries. It's not the night you go out to see art, but it's the night you go out to celebrate art. You meet the people that are making it. If you see something you like, you go back on Saturday. You see it when the galleries open during the week. But as an unparalleled access to meet the artists, to see the cultural players, and to get kind of a broad overview of what you're into, it's an excellent time to do it.
First Fridays has been getting out of control down here in the Crossroads. Now, a lot of people don't know that art happens the rest of the month, and that's really what we got to stress nowadays down here. But we're getting between 6,000 and 10,000 people down here on the First Fridays now, which is great. They're learning and they're getting educated, which is the important thing. I don't really care if people are purchasing, but as long as they're getting educated and how to see and how to evaluate and learn about art. And it's not just collectors, it's young kids, it's parents, and it's kind of turned into a social event.
Kansas City is a great place to make art. It's not necessarily a great place to be an artist. The access to cheap studio space, the Crossroads over the last decade, maybe it's on Troost over the next decade, or the West Bottoms, that gives artists the ability to be entrepreneurial, the do-it-yourself aesthetic of organizing your own show. These are the things that bring Kansas City's reputation out of town. That's what we're known for, is as a self-starter. There hasn't been a dollar to fight over in town until recently in the arts, and so there's always been the impetus of someone who does it is doing it because they believe in it.
It's like a big circus just shaking out down here in the Crossroads. So get out and come down and feel safe. I mean, it's okay down here. We don't bite hard.